Batten down the hatches and lock the door. It's wrestling time. Once more, hi everybody, I'm Ed Whelan. We hope you enjoy the show. I'm aided and abetted by Bulldog Bob Brown. And what are the highlights, he asks, knowing full well what the answer will be?
Well, it's only going to be a great card. You know, you're going to have probably the greatest referee in the world.
That's what I thought, the greatest referee in the world.
A special guest referee. And, of course, you know Ed Whelan. The world's talking about the match. And I'm going to call the match right down the line. You have no fear about that. There'll be no favoritism.
He is going to referee. You're going to referee.
And then we talk about Blackman and Davey Boy Smith. It should be a tremendous hour. But, you know, special guest referee, I've done it in the past. I hold license all over the world to referee big wrestling matches.
You will not. You will not be biased towards the Singh boys.
Not whatsoever.
You won't be biased against Chris Benoit.
Not whatsoever.
I find that difficult to believe. We'll be right back. We're headed into tag team action. The combination of the Cuban Commandos, namely Jerry Morrow and the Cuban Assassin, into the ring against Ron Ritchie and Eddie Watts. Oddly enough, whoa! Did the Cuban fly and Ritchie blew it, and there is another malfunction at the junction. I was going to say the two, Ron Ritchie and Eddie Watts, both out of Winnipeg. Ritchie, the veteran at 245, Watts, the lighter man, and making his way into the business, 215 pounds. Nice young man. The Cuban Commandos, as mentioned. The Assassin, 235 is his weight tonight. And Jerry Morrow checking in at 238. Jürgen Hermann, the referee. There's been some slam bang, slam dunk action here in the early going.
Well, you know, I saw the Winnipeg boys, Ron Ritchie and Eddie Watts, work out at the gym today. And I'll tell you what, they really did look good. And I'll tell you, I asked them what their plans were tonight when they meet the Commandos, a real tough team. He says, we're all set for them. The Cuban Commandos will have their hands full. So, hey, I'm going to watch this match. It's certainly a big match, Ed. And I'll tell you the truth, if these two kids can upset this great veteran team, it's a big feather in their hat.
Oh, you got that right. Well, it is concentrate on the action at mid-ring. That's Eddie Watts against Jerry Morrow. Watts, a very agile young man. The Cuban Assassin coming into the ring. I don't think I ever did tell you, did I? That it's one fall, 20-minute time limit. That's what it is, and we're moving toward the 5-minute mark as young Eddie explodes and does a little house cleaning.
Well, yes, Ed, you know that the world of professional wrestling will be watching this great program. And of course, you know, me and you's pitchers and Jim Davis is on the program this week. It's going to be a hot seller. And goodness gracious, we're being talked about all over the wrestling world. What kind of a great team we really are. We bring wrestling into many thousands of homes. But you know what? The world is going to be watching today, because Bulldog Bob Brown is going to be a special guest referee. And of course, you want to know, Jim Davis wants to know, and you've been asking me, am I calling it down the line? Under no circumstances, I'm favoring anybody. I got a great job to do. I got a license. I really don't want to lose it. And you're going to see a great performance done by Bulldog Bob Brown later on this card.
Yeah. Okay. Why is it that I have this feeling I will believe that when I see that? All right, at mid-ring, it's Jerry Morrow. He's up top. Young Eddie Watts. Look out now. Something's got to give here off those ropes. Oh, no. Boy, he hit him a smack. But Watts is still hanging in there. Caught him coming in. Beautiful timing, good arm drag, down he goes. Young Watts is up top.
That's exciting match, you know. We watched Eddie Watts last week, you know. He's had some tough matches, but this is the best by far that he has looked. And I tell you, him and Richie's looks like a fine team. Maybe we're going to hear from them.
You're being very fair tonight.
You know, like I said, I call him as I see him, Ed.
Right, okay. Right. I knew that. What has he got at ringside? That guy, the Weasel, has he got a stick, a walking cane? I don't know what he has, but look at Ron Ritchie. He's going up top. Down he comes. Does a little hatchet job on the left arm. Jerry Morrow takes him down. Now, Ritchie's very explosive. He can be dangerous. I still cannot believe the subterfuge, do you understand that word, that was involved in your tricking the Benoit combination into you being guest referee of a bout involving Chris Benoit.
Well, Ed, really, I didn't trick anybody. You know, they're looking for a referee that's not biased. Of course, you know.
You made him sign, and then you put your name in the blank space.
Well, I wasn't. They shouldn't have been surprised.
That's disgusting.
They said they'll wrestle with any referee. Didn't you hear him say that? So I just signed my name. I'm going to be a great one. Hey, I'm going to tell you.
I hope we can get to the end of the hour. I'm going to hear that for an hour. Now the little guy, the Weasel, gets tossed on out of there. As he tried to make his way into the ring, that didn't work. Watch this now. Underneath. Cross body block. One, two, just two.
Tremendous cross body block. You know, Eddie Watts did it the right way and almost got the three count on the Cuban Assassin. I'm going to tell you what an upset this is going to be. And it's in the making. I'm watching Eddie Watts. I'm watching Ron Ritchie. And they look like they've been working together for years, and this is their first time as a tag team match.
Well, they're Winnipeg blood brothers, you know. Maybe that makes it. You're Winnipeg.
Not really.
Now, you don't want to admit it. Okay. Look at this. Well, one of the Winnipeg blood brothers is getting hammered right now. And a yellow card goes to Jerry Morrow. Tommy Carr, our timekeeper. Hard to believe he's been in that spot for 41 years.
What do you think of Davey Boy and Blackman? I think it's going to be a contest.
Be a good match.
It's going to be
match.
A great match. And I tell you the truth, if anybody right now is capable of beating Davey Boy and taking him to a limit, you know, Ed, that you know if Blackman finds out about, you know what you call, had a bad case of a shoulder injury last week.
You didn't see him get knocked over the top rope, did you? But he got thrown over the top. Young Watts, over the top. Yeah, you didn't see that. I figured that. The Cuban threw him over the top. Watch this now. Double whammy.
I tell you, when the Commandos get their thing together, to me, they're unstoppable as a team. You know, I just got a report earlier this morning when me and you were doing the television show from South Africa. And they caused a lot of mayhem over there. And they're coming right back here now. And I tell you, when they got their thing together, I don't think there's a team around that could beat them. But then again, they've had their troubles early on in this match. And I don't know, upset or no upset, this is going to be a great match for television.
10 minutes.
You're watching tag team action. Cuban Commandos, the Cuban Assassin, and Jerry Morrow against Ron Ritchie and Eddie Watts, the Winnipeg connection. As Watts cover, one, two, Watts was able to kick his way out.
Ed, I gotta say something to you. I was up in Kelowna and a good couple, good friends of mine, Mr. and Mrs. Ole Olson, we had lunch together and talked about wrestling. He's one of the greatest fans of Ed Whalen. And I told him I'd say hello to you on the television, to Mr. and Mrs. Olson, and listen to this. They've been married for 65 years.
Wow, that's great. And isn't that wonderful?
And they made a beautiful lunch and took me right into their home as their own son.
Well, that's lovely. That's lovely. 65 years. Right now, young Eddie Watts feels like he's been getting pounded for 65 years, I do believe, because he's been taking a whipping lately. Hey, he's a good young man, but he's got a problem here with a couple of experienced scrappers, the Assassin and Morrow. Now, he gets over, makes the tag, but you want to know something? The referee didn't see it. Referee didn't see it. No, he didn't. And here comes the Assassin off the top. There was no tag. It's what you call a phantom tag. There was none.
That's what I tell you about the biased referees. This is why I'm refereeing tonight, Ed.
Well, that's wonderful. I don't want to hear about that. They're chanting out in the crowd, we want a ref. Maybe that's you. They're waiting for you.
Yeah.
Sure they are. Double whammy. We're well past the 10-minute mark now. This is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. I can barely hear myself think, let alone talk. The crowd is really on fire tonight. Morrow is signaling to Bulldog that this one is for him. That was in your honor.
Well, I tell you.
Are you thrilled?
I am thrilled. Listen, I like him as a tag team match. Now, you see, when I tell you the referee is letting this match get out of hand, he should get Richie back to his corner.
Would you hold this?
Ed Whalen, once again, I think, is out of place. Eddie Watts on the floor. Just been humiliated by the Cuban Commandos. Earlier in the match, you know, I was looking at an upset, but now I tell you, if Eddie Watts don't get his thing together, this match is going to be over. Do you think that this was called for, Mr. Whalen?
He's got no business interfering there. No business interfering. Here he goes. Eddie Watts. Oh, did he take a shot to the mouth? Watts taking a pounding here.
Aren't you afraid of getting hurt going after the weasel? What happens if he would hit you with a stick, Ed?
I'd hit him with a chair.
Oh.
Oh. He's got no business interfering. That's the only thing. All I did was hold him off. That's all.
What?
Just held him off. I'm a nonviolent person. There's a two count. Whoa! 2 7/8, would you believe?
What a great match this is turning out to be.
You got to give him the atomic or settle for the squeeze?
Well, they set him up, Ed. They worked on his back. He fell outside the ring here. Jerry Morrow took advantage of him. He's got the bear hug on him. This is what I call, hey, a real pro. Go after him.
Well, here's Jerry Morrow. And he make the tag? He just missed. Just by a fraction as we move toward the 15-minute mark. Watch this, big slam.
15 minutes gone.
He gonna fly. Look out.
There's no one else in professional wrestling that can do better. Now there comes Richie again. I wonder where the yellow... Oh, no sooner said than done.
One yellow card for Ron Richie.
A yellow card. Eddie Watts having quite a lesson here. Can he make the tag? Can he make the tag? He did. Here's Richie. Look at him go. He's exploding against Morrow. Off those ropes. Look out. Nelly. Beautiful drag. Comes in and visits the Cuban. Gives him a little greeting. And away he goes. Oh, now. Richie still working his man. Off those ropes. Over the top. He comes in to take a belt at the kill, but
I sense an upset. I'll tell you what, I think I'm looking at one end, because I tell you, the Cuba Commandos are not looking good at this instant moment. They
okay,
have taken
look at
the
this. Just a two count, but that's because the Cuban managed to interfere. Can Richie and Watts upset? Cover again, one, two. Eddie Watts comes in and he has a look at Jerry Morrow and gives him a shot. Everybody's after everybody. Watts banging him in the corner. We're gonna have a confrontation. Wow. Oh, the Cuban really got bumped. The Cuban gets stomped out of the ring. Just a minute. Oh, yeah, he had the stick. He hit Morrow. He tried to hit Richie.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
The weasel hit his own man. Two, three.
Ed, let me tell you something. I sensed an upset from the opening bell, and I told
away.
You. But I'll tell you what. This
just
is.
Just a minute. Look at this. Look at this. They are going after their own man. They're going after the weasel. Their own manager. How do you like them apples?
I don't know what got into them. I tell you, they didn't look good against Richie and Watts. And I tell you, I don't know what's going to happen now. Here comes the Sings. Now, what about this?
Well, they're trying to rescue. Whoa! They're trying to rescue their own man. And no, sir, they are just going after Morrow and the assassin. Oh, it's clobber time in the ring.
I tell you, I think the Sings did wrong. And I tell you what, they might pay for this. Well, I just watched one of the greatest upsets in professional wrestling. Ron Richie, Eddie Watts, defeating the Cuban Commandos. But there's a little in the background here. There's a little misunderstanding. And my goodness, what are we looking at?
You know what? We don't need the whistle. We don't need the Sings brothers. Because we're ready to take the same brothers right in this ring or any place around the world or in Canada or whatever, and we're gonna put that belt around our waist, because that belt was belonged to the Cuban commander before, and it's they, a pair of yellow cowards that attack us from behind, and then they run. Everybody see they run, but next time or next week, no place to hide and no place to run.
Jerry Morrow, are we looking towards a championship match with the Sings after this?
First of all, Mr. Bulldog Bob Brown, the manager, we don't need that. We come for the commando. We tough. We know what the ball is about. Do you hear me? Listen, Makasin and Vulcan Singh, what you have between and your ways, that will belong to us. Now, Maka, you used to be my partner. I know all you tweet. All you tweet, I know about it. I have some new one you don't know about it.
You're gonna be a well meat to support and to feed the animal over here in the zoo.
What a match would that be? Sings against the Commandos? Wow. We'll be right back. Here's Ed Whelan.
Ah, little dissension in the Karachi Vice ranks.
There's
my
no dissension at all, Whelan. Their history. We can't tolerate ignorance or idiots, and they fit into both of them categories. They don't touch the weasel. They never come after Abu Weasel. He took us to the top of the wrestling world, and we're still in the top of the wrestling world. Maybe they're jealous, Whelan. You know, there's no room for jealousy in this business, in the world. We beat the British Bulldogs. The British Bulldogs beat them. So maybe they figure that's the only way they can get another title shot is take a shortcut and attack our manager, Abu Weasel. They want to rant and rave and they want to fire the weasel. Well, I'll tell you what, it was already in the works in the Karachi Vice. Volk and I, Abu Weasel, we had sat down. It was time to get rid of the riffraff. One Fidel Castro lookalike, one refugee from the Martinique Navy used to paddle around in a canoe. Well, I'll tell you something, you banana-eating, coconut-piling thing, Morrow, and Cuban assassin, you want to get in a wrestling ring with Volkan and I, you get ready, because we don't care who it is. You want to be the two heroes, you come in, and I hope you got some padding. Shut up, Whelan. I hope you got some padding underneath those little G.I. Joe pants, because we're going to beat them right off you.
What do you think?
My brother Mucka just said
The reason why they did this to the Weasel is because of jealousy, because we're the greatest tag team in the world. We've beaten the British Bulldogs. We'll be beaten Benoit, Wellington, anybody. They want to try and get a shot at our title belts through our manager. They got it. If they want it, bring it on.
All right. I don't want to
Don't eat too many bean burritos, Cuban, because if you bend over with Dad,
right.
Just forget it.
I don't want to.
Champion,
I don't want to talk to you.
I'm mixed up.
Get out of
champion,
here.
Number one champion.
We'll be right back. Singles action, Sumo Hara against Kim Shaw. Hara, 225 out of Sapporo, Japan. He's got the Tammy Baker makeup. And Kim Shaw at 240 pounds out of Hamilton. One fall, 20 minutes.
You know, watching that last encounter with the Commandos and the Sinks, I hope they work things out, because I'll tell you what, they're two tremendous teams, and I certainly wouldn't want to see them go against each other.
I would feel terrible.
You would, eh?
Yes, I would.
And I tell you, interviewed them, you know, I think down deep, you know, both teams have made a mistake, and I'm sure they'll correct it and go on amongst the business, because they're two great teams.
Pass me your Kleenex. I'm very moved by this conversation.
I'm sorry.
I really am. I hate to see trouble in the Karachi Vice. What an emotional moment in my career. Oh, well. Anyhow, back to the action. Sumo Hara, how has he looked in some of the bouts you've seen out on the road?
Well, he's looked great. I tell you the truth, he's well-groomed in Japan before he come here, Ed.
Right.
They don't send anybody over here that would make the people in Japanese be humiliated and embarrassed. They send him over here, they're well trained, and he's really, really looked good. And believe me, some great big victories that he has scored since he's been here. And I tell you, everybody thinks Kim Shaw. Well, I'll tell you, Kim Shaw is a good little wrestler. And with a win here today, it just boosts that Sumo Hara right up the ladder. And I'll tell you what, I think he's highly rated right now, isn't he?
Well, he's the number one contender in the mid-heavyweight division behind Chris Benoit. So he has catapulted to the top, edging out Biff Wellington along the way.
Well, yeah, and if Benoit would come out of the closet or come out of his bedroom with the belt.
You're going to be neutral tonight?
Yeah,
you're
no,
a referee.
And defend the championship. Here's a guy you should be worried about instead of Goldie Rogers and Kim Shaw like he has been the last 3 or 4 weeks. This has been my beef with Chris Benoit. There's no doubt in my mind. You say it every week. He's a great athlete. He is a great athlete. But that's not
you
my
are
point.
Wound up tonight, aren't
yes,
you?
But it's
can
not
we
my
watch
point.
The fight?
Okay.
I don't want to talk about you. I don't want to talk about Benoit. I want to talk about the two guys in the ring right now, Hara and Shaw. Wayne Hart is the referee. I can tell you that too.
He got pushed down the ladder a notch or so.
Who's
nobody.
That?
Wayne Hart. Nobody wants him to referee their big matches no more. That's why I'm refereeing later on.
Oh, sure. No, you tricked him. Well, I'm afraid to tell you this, but Wayne Hart has a great reputation, and it's justified. Well respected. Sumo Hara. Boy, he's got quite a jaw lock on this man. I don't know how he is with English. I tried to talk to him once. Maybe he didn't want to talk to me, but he had nothing to say.
I watched him in a workout at the local gym here in town. I couldn't talk to him. I wanted to interview him down there. You know, I bought my little cassette, and I wanted to have a good interview with him, but I couldn't get a word in edgewise. He does not speak English. But let me remind you one thing. All those holds that he put on him, Ed, it's pressure points. He
right,
knows what he's
right.
doing, Ed, and believe me, I'll tell you, he's going to show a lot of people just how tough he is. And I'll tell you
well, what, he's doing it now.
He wrote out, he initialed on a map the other day on a piece of paper in front of me. And you know what he wrote? B-E-N-O-I-T, Benoit.
Really?
Yeah.
You sure it wasn't Benoit, somebody from Japan?
No, it was Benoit.
Oh, okay. That's interesting. I'm thoroughly intrigued. Well, we are moving in on the 5 minute mark, I can tell you that much. And it it's a 20-minute time limit. You're watching Suma Hara, Sapporo, Japan, against Kim Shaw, Hamilton, Canada. Near the 5-minute mark, it's a one-fall affair. Wayne Hart telling Hara he'd better quit his choking.
5 minutes gone. 5 minutes.
And I think Suma Hara, although he has difficulty with the English language, knows the meaning of the yellow card. My goodness, that's ugly makeup. Ugly.
Sharp-looking guy, Ed.
You like that? Well, the purple matches his pants anyhow.
You know, the thing that impresses me about Suma Hara, he takes his time. He's not going to a fire. He's not going to dinner. And he's just going out and taking his time, and he's torturing Kim Shaw right now. He's punishing him, and that's what I like to see. Take it right to him.
Yeah, okay. Well, he's going to get another yellow card if he keeps on with this nonsense. He's got one already. Wayne Hart giving him a verbal warning. Bango. Boy, he is giving Shaw what for. Shaw just cannot get on track, but I spoke too soon. Got him coming in, pulled the pins from under him, and Suma Hara is not hurt, he's just startled. But a couple of elbow smashes, and Suma Hara doesn't look that cocky anymore.
No, he's, and I tell you what, Kim Shaw's a stocky little individual. You know, I think he runs about 230 or 240, but you know, he's built like a little package of dynamite. And I tell you, we're going to hear a lot of things from Kim Shaw. Kim Shaw's learning now.
That's it.
And he's learning the hard way.
Beautiful suplex. Pulled his man down. Covers one and a two, and that's off. Just a two count. Suma Hara against Kim Shaw. One, two, just two. That's off.
You know what I like about Kim Shaw now? He's taking it right to him, and he's not giving him a chance to breathe. And this is the sign of a good little athlete. And I tell you, Kim Shaw, keep right on top of him, and he'll win this match.
Well, now he's taking his time. You see, took his time, didn't stay on top of him. And, well, he hit his head on the deck, so he's got a problem. Watch this now. Suma Hara going to work. We're moving toward the 10-minute mark. He's going to pull him over. You betcha. One, two, three. He got him. Nothing to it.
Beautiful suplex. This is the front face lock. Got the both arms behind his neck and brought him over. And it was done the way you're trained to do it, Japanese style. It was a tremendous win for Suma Hara, Ed.
Davey Boy Smith, a new North American heavyweight champion and certainly an extremely popular one. Davey Boy is a little worried about the way your shoulder got banged around last week.
Well, you know, Ed, I would like to come in the ring tonight and show all the people that I could give Steve Blackman a North American heavyweight championship belt. But the IWA, the officials of the IWA said that I'm not fit enough to give a championship match. Plus, Steve Blackman is up in the rankings, but he's not in the top rankings to face me. And I told all the people that I would give Steve Blackman the dream of his lifetime. I would give him a title match. Well, Blackman, tonight's tonight. You got to show David Boy Smith that you can beat me in the middle of the ring. And if you can beat me in any way possible, then David Boy Smith will give you a shot at the North American heavyweight belt.
Okay, simple as that, Davey Boy. Thank you very much, Davey Boy Smith. And now here's Jim Davies.
Biff Wellington and Chris Benoit, the good news is you've got a crack at the International Tag Team Championship. The bad news, guest referee is Bulldog Brown.
Well, that's right, Jim. There's always good news and there's bad news. Bulldog Bob Brown, guest referee tonight. You know, we're going to be watching you, Bob Brown, but we can't pay all our attention to you. We got two tough big guys in the ring tonight. Me and Chris have trained a long, hard time for this. We got a title shot tonight. We're going to make the most of it.
Chris, it'll be the speed of you and Biff against the size of the Singh brothers.
Jim Davies, it's enough of a challenge going into the ring against the champions, or two of the biggest men in the territory right now. But to have Bob Brown as a referee is even more of a challenge. Bob Brown, I'll tell you what, we're going to be watching you. And you pull one thing off, and you're going to have both of us to deal with. Mukha Singh, Bokan Singh, we've been training all week for this match. We're ready. We're going to walk out of here with a belt around our waist.
And the action, I'm certain it will be action, involves lethal Larry Cameron and Goldie Rogers. Cameron, Lankomer Lumpen, 260 pounds out of Chicago, against Goldie Rogers, who checks in at 223 out of Hollywood, California. And Mr. Cameron is undefeated.
Have you noticed Goldie Rogers took his jacket off real quick tonight? I think if he didn't, Cameron would have torn it off.
Yeah, I think you're quite, they're shaking hands. What is this? Love Brothers. Out go the shades. Except Goldie Rogers is going to do his usual shtick. Takes a long time to get him off. And now these two blood brothers kind of smile at each other and shook hands. Shake hands again. Isn't this tender? This is a tender moment.
You know, Cameron's not fooling me for one moment.
There you go. He's not fooling me at all.
Can I call it or can I call it?
Look at him. He hammers away immediately, gets the big headbutt, and the greeting, the friendship, the brotherhood, it's all over. Lethal Larry. You know, you look at Larry Cameron, he now has risen the number one contender for the North American title. He deserves that ranking.
Should have been number one way before Davey Boy Smith was number one. Believe me, this guy here's
got a great record.
Hey, you can't take nothing away from Cameron. And do you know, I'll tell you what, Ed, and he's waited his turn. He's defeated everybody they put him against. And I'll tell you, he's really impressed a lot of people here in Canada, especially me. I'll tell you the truth, there's nobody he's scared of. He goes in the ring, and I tell you, you know what I like him most of all? He goes in there and he dishes it out. He can take it. But most of all, he's a crippler.
Oh, hey. Well, okay. He just stopped an elbow there. Then a close-in clothesline. Rogers is not to be toyed with. Look at that. He's outweighed by nearly 40 pounds, and he's dishing it out. There's a two count, but Cameron's very strong.
This is a match like Ron Ritchie and Eddie Watts that open up our card. Hey, listen, Goldie Rogers is capable of beating anybody. Hey, this guy's a great veteran, and I'll tell you what, Cameron better not take him lightly.
I don't think he is, because right now he's getting pummeled. Cameron has got that I am tired of you look on his face.
The old BC football team with football tackle. I think now he's setting him up for the big power slam.
Watch it now. Let's see.
There we go.
There we go. Big power. One, two, three. It's all over. Bang, bang, bang.
Well, you know, Larry was in trouble for 30 seconds. He came out of it like a great athlete he really is. And he came back and he beat Goldie Rogers. And this is a big win, because I tell you, Goldie Rogers is no pushover.
Lethal Larry Cameron undefeated. It took you 3 minutes, 15 seconds. 3 minutes, 15. You're getting a little confident, I think.
Well, Mr. Edge, you should know me by now that my middle name is Mr. Confidence. But that's not important right now. Somehow, Davey Boy Smith, you end up with that championship belt. But it don't make no difference. Some kind of fluke, some kind of freak of nature, you end up with the belt, Davey Boy. But it don't make no difference. sooner or later, it's gonna come down to me and you. And you will meet your creator, David Boy. Let me tell you something. I don't know who gave you that name, David Boy. But when they put the boy in it, they named you right because they knew that you would never grow up to be a man and to be able to hold that North America Championship belt, Davy Boy. Right. You got to be a man. And I tell you what, it's gonna come down to just me and you. You can run, you can hide, but Lethal Larry always gets his man.
All right. Flying Brian Pillman, you got quite an ovation as you walked in. People were handing you roses. You must be very excited. They want you to win that bout with Johnny
Smith.
Time and time again.
I've traveled all over the world. You're not going to find a greater enthusiastic crowd than right here in Western Canada. And I relish the opportunity anytime I get to come out here and perform for them, because with them behind me, I've had some of my greatest efforts in the ring. Now, as far as tonight's concerned, you know, Johnny, I want to alert you to a little fact. The only reason you slimed and slithered your way out of that sewer in Manchester and was able to enjoy the great life of a professional wrestler, the greatest sport in the world, the traveling, the notoriety, the acclaim, the only reason you're enjoying that today is the Dynamite Kid. The Dynamite Kid came over here, broke the size barrier. He was the first wrestler to prove that lightning speed, endurance, intensity, quickness could win championships. He's the one that broke the barrier so guys like you could enjoy the nice successes that wrestling has to offer. So let me tell you something, Johnny. I'm going to dedicate my efforts in the ring tonight to the Dynamite Kid. Now, I know you've been cruising and bruising. Let me tell you something, pal. You're not going on any cruise tonight, because when you step in this ring with this lean, mean flying machine, you've booked yourself on a flight with Air Pillman, and I'm going to give you a one-way, all-expense-paid ticket to the promised land.
Smith having a jarring match with the crowd. Why isn't he fighting the fighter?
Well, that's a mistake that Johnny Smith is just making, you know. He better not take Pillman too lightly. And he better get the job done on him now instead of walking up to the top rope and arguing with the wrestling fans, because Pillman is capable of coming right behind him and defeating the guy. So Johnny Smith is fooling around right now. I predicted it was going to be a tough match, and Johnny Smith is taking it right to him.
Well, he's certainly doing that. The question right now is it a choke? There's one. The arm goes down two. If it's three, it's over. He's hanging on. Pillman trying to jam his way out of trouble. He does.
10 minutes gone. 10 minutes.
Folds him down. One. That's all he got. No, he got the two, says the referee. Boy, this crowd is very volatile. Hard to hear your own voice. We're past the 10-minute mark.
It's been an exciting match, Ed. I'll tell you, back and forth. And when you're talking about action, hey, don't turn that television down, because we're getting it all right here. And Ed, I'll tell you, you can't ask for a better match. And I'll tell you, it's about even, but Johnny is putting it to him. Ever since he went through the rope onto the floor, I just can't help but think that has let down Pillman just a little bit.
Smith has him jammed. Gives him three shots there.
And you know, it's a big match for both of them. You know, a win here by either one of them, hey, you'd have to put him right up the ladder there to be challenged the Davey Boy Smith for the North American Heavyweight Championship. This is what kind of contenders that I like. The winner of this match wins.
Yep. Johnny Smith is ranked number four contender, and Brian Pillman number five. At the very least, they would change positions on the ladder. Turn around. Oh, man. Oh, man, did he hit that rope. One, two, I thought he had knocked him out.
And you know what? I think Wayne Hart could have counted three. I thought he was down.
Devastating collision in the corner with that turnbuckle and the throw to Bryant Pillman. He's again dishing out the punishment, trying to wear his man down. There's Johnny Smith. And it's worked very effectively of late. Oh, he's got him almost out.
I would have been the referee. I think I'd have stopped this match. I think that Pillman now is in need of help. I don't know where he's going to get it from. Only him can come back. I tell you what, he looks in bad shape then.
Smith is all over him. Oh, mamma mia. Here he comes. What a splash. Caught him. Got him, got the knees up. Pillman at a point in time when it looked like he had him, miscalculated.
Gotta watch out for Johnny Smith. I tell you, when you think he's down and out, bingo, he comes right out of it. I just like the guy. You know I like Johnny Smith. The guy's a great competitor, and he's been a great competitor ever since he come over here from Britain. And he's given the wrestling fans some tremendous wrestling. Some of the greatest matches that I saw on this wrestling card.
Watch him now. He's got Pillman in all sorts of trouble. Pillman trying to jam his way out. Turns it around. Look at that. Smith is saying, no, no, no. Why is he going up there?
Why didn't he cover him when he had him down is what I want to know.
He took forever.
You're right, Ed.
Just two. Close call. Close call. Smith is showing the effects of a tough fight, too.
I don't know how long this match can carry on. I'll tell you what. They battled it out now for 15 minutes, and I'll tell you, I thought it was over in five or six different occasions. And bingo, they're both here.
We're
at the 15-minute mark. It's one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Turn around. Close line, and Brian is flying.
He caught him with a tremendous clothesline coming out of the corner, and he's softened up Johnny Smith. I'll tell you, they've done everything to each other, and there's still no winner, Ed. I'll guarantee you this has been the best match I saw for 2 or 3 weeks.
Watch it now, just a two count. Smith has a problem right now, and that adds to the problem. Well, he can't fly from there, goodness gracious. Whoa! Just caught him going by, one, two. He got the leg up. Close call on a long distance flight. Pillman's got him in trouble. One. Just a minute, he's pounding. I thought he was going to take the count on him. Oh, watch this. Watch this. What did you do that for?
I'll tell you why I did that. All this competition in Stampede Wrestling, know the British Bruiser. He's cruising and he's bruising. He's steamrolling everybody. I've been back in the territory 3 weeks. I've had 3 wins in under 10 minutes. Last week I said I wasn't going to be responsible for what I did to Brian Pillman. I proved to all these morons, I keep my word. I do what I say. I can live up to what I say. Brian Pillman, I told you I wouldn't be responsible for the consequences. You stepped in the ring with a British Bruiser. And Ron Ritchie, you ambushed me from behind, you yellow coward. Come and face me, man on man.
Why did you use a chain? What do you need that for? You're such a hot shot. What do you need a chain
for? I need a chain because I want that Dynamite Kid to tape that on his VHS machine. And I want to watch it in slow motion, Dynamite, because I'm coming after you. And next week, Ritchie, it's me and you. And this egg reminds me a lot of you. It's kind of round, it's kind of stupid, and it's easy to break just like this.
That's wonderful.
And that's what I'm going to do to you, Ritchie. I'm going to bust you up. I'm going to tear you in pieces.
Yeah, all right.
And you're going to get it from the Bruiser, because the Bruiser is cruising, and he's bruising.
Johnny, number one,
get out of here. Yuck.
You know, let me remind you something, Ron Ritchie. You've got quite a thing going by sticking your nose into other people's business when you don't really belong. I thought Johnny Smith went on to beat Pillman if you wouldn't have stuck your nose in. Now you want a match with Johnny Smith. Tell me in your words, how do you think you control this madman?
You know, I told myself I was going to be cool, calm, and collective when I come out here. But it's hard to be cool! It's hard to be calm! And it's hard to be collective when you see something like that happening. You know, Johnny Smith, you and I are going to go out of here in the pavilion next week, mister. And I'm telling you one thing. The roof is going to blow up. Oh, mayhem is going to break loose. You try to end the man's career. Well, I'm going to tell you what, Johnny Smith. We're going to see who is going to walk out the winner.
I wonder if they could bring a straitjacket and tie this maniac up. We'll be right back.
The semi-windup, non-title affair, one fall, 45-minute time limit. Davey Boy Smith, 250-pounder from Leeds, England. Steve Blackman, a 270, out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And we are at the 2.5-minute mark. There you go.
You like me all dressed up like this?
You're getting all dressed up to be a referee, are you?
Yeah, I'm on next. I just finished coming back from the dressing room. They're looking after Brian Pillman in the dressing room. He looks to be, at this present time, in pretty bad shape. I don't know what his extent of injuries is, but it seems to be his neck. So it looks like he could have an injury for some time yet.
Well, not pretty at all, given the manner in which it was administered by Johnny Smith. Let's concentrate on this match, however.
This is a big match for Steve Blackman. Now, I've watched Steve Blackman work out now for the last 2.5 weeks, getting prepared for this match. Now, he's went through some of the greatest workouts I've ever saw any athlete do. I tell you, 3 and 4 hours in the morning, 2 and 3 hours in the late afternoon. And I tell you, talking to him before the match, he said, Bulldog, I've got nothing to lose and everything to gain. What a statement by a great individual. He's going to go in here, and he wants to beat Davey Boy Smith. He wants to upset him. He thinks it'll be the greatest upset in professional wrestling. And I got to agree with him. And I tell you, Blackman is looking better than I've ever saw him. But it won't be easy.
Okay, you never quit, do you?
It won't be easy.
All right. All right, let's watch the match, okay? Good heavens. This a Bulldog Bob Brown hour or what?
Tell me something about Davey Boy. You know him better.
I know Davey Boy. I watched him in here as a raw rookie. I saw him, as a matter of fact, I heard about him when he made a debut at age 15 in Great Britain. And I've watched him to develop into one of the most outstanding wrestlers around. Primarily, certainly I agree with you, noted for his tag team affiliation with the Dynamite Kid and the British Bulldog Tag. But as a singles wrestler, well, he's proven himself, hasn't he? He has the North American heavyweight belt. Blackman. Appears to be a little bit frustrated.
5 minutes.
We've just hit the 5 minute mark. One fall, 45 minute time limit. Jürgen Hermann, the third man in the ring. Blackman working his way to his feet. And a tie up on the ropes. All right, here we go again.
Watching Davy Boy Smith, I don't know about you, Ed, over the last couple of months. He's got a very quick temper, hasn't he?
Oh, yeah, he can snap all right. Oh, that caught him in the midsection. Oh, that caught him in the midsection.
Well, Davy Boy Smith tried to put the crucifix and the backslide on him. But, you know, he fell down, and now he's really injured his ribs. And I tell you, he looks like he's in a lot of pain.
Blackman with those quick feet of his. He is giving Davy Boy Smith quite a battle here. Well, I have watched Blackman develop as time has gone on. And although he took a funny turn, Karachi Vice direction, there's no doubting his ability.
His whole wrestling career turned around. I don't know what the Karachi Vice had done for him, but I tell you what, he's really came on strong and won some great big matches. I tell you what, I got to be proud of him, you know. He's taking it right to Davy Boy Smith. He knows what he's got to do. He's got to go out and win.
Boy, oh boy, he is pitching. And Davy Boy is catching. No ifs, buts, no maybes. Blackman is certainly leading on points.
Well, just a while ago when he did the crucifix and mix, you know, Blackman sensed there's something wrong with Davy Boy. He, you know, kind of maybe injured his ribs. So now he's taking it right to him with a hammerlock. And you know, when you got your arm twisted up, right up behind your back, you know what that affects? Your whole side of your ribs. And I think Blackman's very smart. He's doing
it. He's also going after that shoulder that was hurt last week.
You're very true, Ed.
Harley Race and Don Morocco went after that shoulder after the title had been won by Davy Boy. Atomic drop and down he goes. And incidentally, Morocco and Race were both suspended.
Yeah, you know, that's what I couldn't figure out. They appealed the suspension, you know, but it didn't work. They are suspended to a further hearing. But I could see one guy getting suspended, but not two great athletes like Morocco and Race. I think it was a miscarriage of justice, Mr. Whalen.
I thought you'd say that. You're watching Davy Boy Smith against Steve Blackman. One fall, 45-minute time limit. The crowd is rather electrified by the fact that Blackman is thoroughly dominating proceedings here. Jürgen Hermann takes a look as we move toward the 10-minute mark. Davy Boy Smith, with a great effort, got a kick in, But his ribs are hurting. His shoulder obviously is hurting. And there's Blackman going after the aforementioned shoulder, and he's going to do it again. No, he's not. No, he's not.
10 minutes gone. 10 minutes.
Tommy Carr telling us it's the 10-minute mark. One fall, 45-minute time limit. Headbutt by Smith. Who's going over top? There's your answer.
Well, a suplex like that, Ed, hurts them both. It's quite a jar to anybody's back. Now, even if you're given a suplex, you take the big lump of it. I'll tell you the truth, Davey Boy is injured right now. And I tell you, you could see it, I could see it. And he's still favoring his shoulder and his arm and his ribs. And Blackman's taking advantage of it. And while he should, if he's got any intentions of winning this match.
Watch this. Boy, he rubbed him down his back with that drop kick at close range. And again, the exchange, but this time, Blackman going over the top. And both men look weary right now. They've had 10 and a half minutes of solid action. Look at this.
This is something new by Davey Boy Smith. I really don't know what kind of a hold it is, but it looks like it's going to be affected because Blackman's in some kind of a pain right now.
He pulls him in. Boy, I can feel the thigh muscles right there. Look at this.
That's the greatest. I have never saw that move before. But I'll tell you what, he got Blackman. He's got Blackman down now.
Boy, I think you could say he hung him out to dry. We're about a dozen minutes into this match. Semi-windup. It is non-title. Davey Boy Smith, the reigning champion, said earlier that he would give Blackman the title shot if Blackman were to win tonight. And look at those quick feet.
Oh, tremendous karate kick to the back of the head and put Davey Boy Smith right down in the mat.
Smith is struggling in this match. But he was advised by medics not to fight tonight, primarily because of his bad shoulder. He's defied the doctors. He's in the ring. And I think he's paying for it. That's all, just two.
You're not going to beat Davey Boy Smith with a covering like this. You know, if you're going to beat the guy, if you got a chance to beat him for the title, hey, you got to be better than this. And I'll tell you right now, Davey Boy Smith has been on the receiving end of some bad punishment in the last few minutes.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Davey Boy saw him coming in. Stepped aside, and you saw the results. Smith with a rally here. Just at a point in time when it looked like it was lights out. Is he going to slam him? Here comes the power. He turns on the engine. Bango covers one. Two. No, not quite.
You know, any other wrestler will probably wouldn't have lifted his shoulder. But as tough as Steve Blackman, he barely lifted, and he's back in the match again.
Well, maybe he's got a ways to go because he's still moving with difficulty. Oh, there goes the shoulder. The shoulder again.
Right into the steel post, Ed. And I'll tell you what, I thought it was a silly part of Davey Boy Smith going outside the ring after Blackman. Because, you know, Blackman was kind of injured himself and the referee was putting the count on him. Now Davey Boy got thrown in shoulder first into the post and he's really favoring the shoulder.
Blackman greets him, not exactly with a lovable welcome. Turn around. Look out. Oh, no. One, two, three. Blackman got him. Blackman got him.
See, Ed, I spotted something 3 or 4 minutes ago. Davey Boy Smith was favoring his leg. He was favoring his ribs. And, hey, Blackman went out, and he punished Davey Boy Smith, and he punished him. There's not much more he could take.
He's got a title shot now. Okay, here's Jim Davies.
Steve Blackman, you're full of surprises. You surprised a lot of your fans when you joined Karachi Vice, and you surprised a lot of people tonight beating the North American heavyweight champ in a non-title affair.
That's right. Says, no title match. I got to prove myself worthy. I got more than prove myself worthy. That belt should be around my waist right now.
A title shot is what you want. I'm sure a title shot is what you'll get.
It's exactly what I want. I did it once, I can do it again. He's gonna go down next time too.
Well, you're not making any friends, but this was a definitely not exactly a dirty performance. You wrestled well in there.
So I do what I have to win. That's all that matters. I want that belt around this waist.
And you predict that's gonna happen?
That's right. I'm not gonna be satisfied though. It's right here.
Okay, that's Steve Blackman. He wants that North American Heavyweight Championship. Now, let's go to Ed Whalen.
We had planned at this moment to talk to Davey Boy Smith, but he really messed up his ankle, even more than his shoulder, even more than his ribs. He's unable to come out here, but he says that he has accepted the challenge of Steve Blackman. He will keep his promise, give Blackman a title fight next week. Okay? We'll be right back. So at close range, the challengers can get into difficulty. That's pretty obvious. Watch out now. Small package. 1, 2.
10 minutes gone. 10 minutes.
The referee came out a little battered there as Wellington was thrown at him. Big slam. Benoit broke it up, and he's being warned. There was no tag. There was no tag. Makhan Singh came in there without benefit of tag. The referee is now asking if you have. He said you didn't tag, get out. Well, how about that? How about that? What a job he's doing. Amazing. Main and final event. The reigning international tag team champions, Makhan and Makhan Singh, against challengers Chris Benoit and Biff Wellington. We're moving toward the 15-minute mark, 1 hour time limit. Whoa, look at this. Beautifully maneuvered by Wellington, and Bulldog Bob Brown has the crowd in a state of astonishment. He's done a good job. Wellington knocked him down outside. Well, everybody's after everybody, and Brown is trying to get this thing into shape once again and back into the ring. Slam into the concrete outside. Now, I would ask Brown, where's the yellow card? He always sits here and says, where's the yellow card?
Well, he does say that, but in fairness to Bob Brown, he has been calling an extremely fair match. He has been on the Sing Sing boys for all their infractions. It's not like he's shown any bias, and the people just cannot believe that he isn't biased.
I don't believe it either. But then I even stopped believing in the tooth fairy, you know?
Well, you got to know that when the Sing Sing boys are not pleased with the refereeing, when Makhan Singh looks down at you and says, the trouble with Bob Brown is he spent too much time sitting beside you, Ed Whalen, then you know Brown must be doing a decent job in there.
Yes, you've got that right. Watch this. Good power. Singh just hammering away now. The early going, it was all Wellington and Benoit. Referee's done a good job. He's been very physical. He stopped a lot of punches before they could get thrown. Over the top. Over the top. Referee didn't see it. There's no question about what happened. Bulldog is listening to the crowd, too, and the crowd is almost cheering for him.
Bulldog Bob Brown, a fan favorite. We've died and gone to heaven.
Watch this. Double whammy. Oh! How sweet it is! He's got to make a tag. Can't quite do it. This is for the tag team belts. Well, well. Bulldog Bob Brown, special guest referee. Just a solid job so far. Giant suplex. One, two, just two. He gives a little stutter step in there. Did you notice that?
A very distinctive method of counting by Bulldog Bob Brown, who has done a credible job. The man who must be worried right now is Biff Wellington. He has spent far too much time inside the ring. He desperately needs to make that tag.
Well, let's see what gives here. There it is. Here comes Benoit. Benoit going to work on Mukund Singh. He grabs Mukund, gives him a shot. Then he takes a look at the great big guy, drives him into the corner. Benoit's all over the big man. Benoit making the challenge for the belts right here. Caught him with the elbow going by. Here's the cover. It's broken up by Boken. Power slam again, or rather the suplex, I should say. I'm getting a little carried away here, too, but look at the job that Chris Benoit is doing right here, right now. Well, just a minute. Just a minute. What was that? What was that? He threw him over the top.
Bulldog propelled Benoit over the top rope.
He did it. Bulldog did that. And I swear it looked intentional. Here he comes with a big Aunt Jemima. Oh, my. Oh, my. There's the three count, but just a minute. I can't believe what happened there. Bulldog did that intentionally. I swear he did a straight-ahead thing. He did a straight-ahead thing. And now Benoit, recognizing what's gone wrong, he's getting a little excited. Here comes Boken. Just a minute, what's going on here? What's going on here? They've got two of them after a little Benoit. What's he doing? What do you think you're doing? What are you doing?
Just a minute now.
You got no business.
Just a minute. You don't understand.
You don't hold the guy and slap him around like
you,
that.
You don't understand.
Diamond, he came at me.
Darn right I did.
And I had to go.
I had to move out of the way.
Now, just a minute now. Whatever you say don't make a damn bit of difference to me, Eddie Bradley.
It makes a difference to me.
So what are you going to do about it?
What am I going to do about it? I know that I can convince the promoter that you will take this guy on. And I hope he cleans your clock. That's what he deserves. That's what you deserve. That's what he deserves, Chris. Take him on.
You've gone one step too far, Bob Brown. I'm telling you, you've gone one step too far. Next week, Bob Brown, I want you to put your name on the dotted line. And I'll tell you what, Bob Brown, you're going to be hanging up your boots once and for all, because when I'm finished with you and this ring, you're gonna be on the way to the hospital.
Yeah, I don't want to talk to you. What do you want to say? I won't come down there. You think I want to stand with those guys? What?
What does he want?
He wants you.
Okay, he wants me?
Yes.
There's two things. Just a minute now, don't let me. I want to say one thing. There's two things. If he wants me, I'll agree. But there's two things. Number one, he don't be in his corner. And number two, there'll be no television allowed. Because I tell you what I want to do. I don't want the Bleeding Heart Society and the churchgoers to get after me for what's going to happen to the kid.
Stipulation. I want a bigger microphone about that long and made out of concrete. Get out of here. Get out of here! Well, I think you'll agree it's been a different night. I got a little carried away. I apologize for that. But under the circumstances, I don't know. I'd probably wind up doing it again. I must tell you, let me see. Next week, we have the Commandos against the Sing Sing Boys. Benoit against Brown. As you have noticed, I'm sure, there's no television. Blackman takes on Davey Boy Smith. Davey Boy Smith banged up in the dressing room. Hopefully, he'll be ready to go. And we have a new fighter in the territory by the name of the Grim Reaper. He's about 6'6", 200. No, it's over 300 pounds. And he's a masked man. Whew, if we live long enough, we'll see you next week at the same time. But in the meantime and in between time, that's it. Another edition of TSN Wrestling. Bye-bye now.